Hello students, welcome for today's video lecture of Ganit Pravinya. Today we are going to learn very important topic, that is divisibility test. Okay, divisibility test. Last year in 4th standard also we have learned this topic. So this year for Ganit Pravinya again we are going to revise it. Okay, divisibility test. Before learning divisibility test, you must know what is mean by divisible numbers. You must know what is mean by divisible numbers. In last lecture also we have seen this divisible numbers means what? Or divisible means what? So when any number, suppose the number is 10, number is 10 and we want to divide 10 by 2. We have to divide 10 by 2. So we have to check that whether 10 is divisible by 2 or not. 10 is divisible by 2 or not. When it will be divisible by 2? When we will divide 10 by 2 and in this process at the end we will get remainder 0. If it is leaving remainder 0, that means 10 is divisible by 2. So see, let's divide, if you divide 10 by 2, 2 5s are 10, correct? 2 5s are 10. So here remainder is 0 minus 0 0, 1 minus 1 0. Remainder is here 0, correct? That means 10 is exactly divisible by 2. So 10 is divisible by 2. You can say 10 is divisible by 2. Instead of 10, suppose we are taking 11. And if you want to check whether 11 is divisible by 2 or not. Now see, we have to divide 11 by 2. But 11 is not there in the table of 2, correct? So we will take smaller number than 11, that is 10. 2 5s are 10. Now here if you will subtract 1 minus 0, 1 and 1 minus 1, 0. So in this process when we divided 11 by 12, 11 by 2, we got remainder 1, not 0. That means what, you know? 11 is not divisible by 2. 11 is not divisible by 2. Understood? So this 10 is in the, when we divided 10 by 2, we got remainder 0. That means 10 is divisible by 2. Okay, understood? Divisible means what? Divisible means that number is exactly divisible, means it leaves remainder 0 when we divide it. Okay? So now why I am telling this divisible numbers? Because see, if we want to divide any number by 2 or 3 or 4 or any number, if you want to divide any large number by small number like 2, 3, 4, 5 and all the time it's not possible or it's not convenient, we can say reasonable that yes, let us divide this step by step. So if there is large number like 7 digit, 8 digit or 9 digit, for example, I will tell you, suppose there is 92,47,538. Okay, this number is there and we have to divide it by 2. We have to divide it by 2 and we have to check whether this number is divisible by 2 or not. We have to check whether this 92,47,538 is divisible by 2 or not. That means if we divide this number by 2, will we get remainder 0? That means it is divisible or not. That we have to check. Then what you will do, you will divide this step by step. You will divide one by one digit, correct? So it will take 5 or 6 or 7, more than that minutes, more time, right? So if you know the divisibility test, now here is the use of divisibility test. To check whether the given number is divisible by the particular number or not. So if you know the divisibility test, within a fraction of minute, you can tell this number, this much large number is divisible by 2 or not. Okay? So you for these divisibility tests are necessary. If you want to divide this number by 3, and we have to check whether this number is divisible by 3 or not, then you will divide it, it will take more time. It is time consuming method if you divide one by one. Instantly you will get the answer whether this number is divisible by 3 or not if you know the divisibility test of 3. Okay, so for this we must learn or we need to learn the divisibility test. Okay, test divisibility test means these are some properties, we can say there are some properties or patterns. Those patterns we have to learn. Okay, now what is first divisibility test is test of 2. That means which numbers are divisible by 2, how to identify whether the given numbers are divisible by 2 or not. Now yesterday we learned even numbers. Do you remember even numbers? Yes, even numbers means the numbers which are divisible by 2. Or another definition of even numbers we have seen, the numbers having the last digit or ones place digit 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8. They are called even numbers. And even numbers were divisible by 2, correct? So the test of 2 or how to identify whether the given numbers are divisible by 2 or not, if the units place digit that is ones place digit of the number is 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8, then the number is divisible by 2. See, what is test of 2 or what is divisibility test of 2? If the number has 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8 at the ones place, then it is divisible by 2. Then it is divisible by 2. Means any number, 7 digit, it may be 7 digit, 8 digit or 9 digit. If its last digit is 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8, then that number is divisible by 2. Okay, blindly we can say if the last digit is 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8, within a fraction of second we can say that yes, that number is divisible by 2. Understood? For example, I'll tell you. Just now we have seen one number, 92,47,534. Now see, this is large number, bigger number, big number. If you want to check whether this number is divisible by 2, we need to divide, correct? But it is time consuming method, time wasting method, right? It will take more time. So if you know this test, if you go by the test, last digit, check the last digit, 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8. Now check the last digit here, last digit is 4. And according to the divisibility test of 2, what divisibility test of 2 says, if last digit is 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8, then that number is divisible by 2. Okay, so here last digit is 4. Last digit is 4. Its last digit is 4. So it is divisible by 2. Yes, so it is divisible by 2. Understood? So if last digit is 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8, then that number is divisible by 2. It's very easy. Divisibility test of 2 is very easy. Okay, 5 examples I am giving to you. You have to solve this way. You have to write this way. Its last digit is 4, so it is divisible by 2. If last digit is other than this 5, means other than 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8, then you have to mention likewise. Its last digit is suppose 3. If its last digit is 3, so it is not divisible by 2. Its last digit is 5, so it is not divisible by 2. Its last digit is 6, so it is divisible by 2. Likewise, a statement you have to write while solving, okay? So, five examples I am giving here. Okay. So these four examples you have to solve by yourself. You have to check whether these given numbers are divisible by 2 or not. Okay. Write this divisibility test in your notebook. Write this example and below it solve these four examples. Check these four numbers whether they are divisible by 2 or not. Okay. If they are divisible, then why they are divisible, that you have to write. If they are not divisible, then why they are not divisible, that you have to write. Understood? So this was the divisibility test of 2. Let's learn divisibility test of 5. It's very easy. Test of 5 is very easy. How to identify whether the given number is divisible by 5 or not? Means if you divided that number, will we get remainder 0 or not? That means it is divisible by 5 or not. That we are going to learn here in the test of 5. Now what is the trick or idea of test of 5 or understanding whether the given number is divisible by 5 or not? Let's see. If you have seen table of 5, see 5 1s are 5, 5 2s are 10, 5 3s are 15, 5 4s are 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, 55, 60, likewise. Now if you see here, these are multiples of 5, as they are in table of 5, that means they are multiples of 5. And multiples of 5 means all these numbers are divisible by 5. If you divide any number, you will get remainder 0. That means these numbers are divisible by 5. Now what is pattern here? See, if you observe their last digit, 5, 0, 5, 0, 5, 0, 5, 0, 5, 0, 5, 0. See, in all the numbers, their last digit is 5 or 0. So with this we can conclude that the numbers which are divisible by 5, they have 0 or 5 at their ones place. Okay. So if the number has the digit 0 or 5 at the ones place, then they are divisible by, then they are divisible by 5. Understood? If the number has 0 or 5 at the ones place, then they are divisible by 5. Understood? So this is the divisibility test of 5. How to check, how to identify whether given number is divisible by 5 or not. What you have to do, just you have to check their last digit. If last digit is 0 or 5, then that number is divisible by 5. Understood? The question will be asked likewise. Check whether the given numbers are divisible by 5 or not. So you have to go by this way. So now see, for example, I'll give you.
One crore, 30 lakh, 42,565.
This is large number, big number. We have to check whether it is divisible by 5 or not. So instead of dividing this number by 5 and step by step finding answer, we will get remainder 0. Till that, it will take lot of time. So to check whether it is divisible by 5 or not, what we must know? We must know the divisibility test of 5. And it is, the divisibility test of 5 says, check the last digit. If last digit is 0 or 5, then yes, it is divisible by 5. So in this number, see the last digit, ones place digit, 5. We want 0 or 5, correct? So here there is 5, that means this number 1,30,42,565 is divisible by 5. Okay. So how to write? its last digit is 5, so it is divisible by 5. So it is divisible by 5. Clear? Or if there is 0, then also it is divisible by 5. If there is digit other than 0 or 5, then you have to write this way. Its last digit is suppose 3, then it is, so it is not divisible by 5 if there is 3 at the end, okay? Or if there is 8, then its last digit is 8, so it is not divisible by 5. Understood? 4 examples I am giving here. Okay, so solve these examples in this way. Underline the last digit and check whether it is 0 or 5. Okay, then test of 10. We have seen test of 2, test of 5, and next we are going to learn test of 10, divisibility test of 10. It is very easy. Again, I am writing here table of 10 to understand the pattern in the multiples of 10. See, 10. To the 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100, there will be 110, 120 and so on. So if these are in the table of, these numbers are in the table of 10 means these are multiples of 10. And you know the multiples are divisible by 10, okay? Multiples of 10 will be divisible by 10. So if you see all these numbers as they are divisible by 10, and if you see the pattern, what you are observing? Yes, you are right. Their last digit is 0. In every multiple of 10, last digit is 0. So it's, is it? If the last, the number has, if the number has the digit zero at the ones place, then they are then it is divisible by 10. Last, if the last digit of that number is 0, then it is divisible by 10. Okay, for example, see this number 6,94,24,050. Okay, so we have to check, the question will be like this, check whether the given number is divisible by 10 or not. So what we have to do is, we can divide this and we can find, but it is time consuming method, so we will use the test, divisibility test of 10. We know the divisibility test of 10, that is, if the last digit is 0, if the last digit is 0, then the number is divisible by 10. So underline the last digit, yes, it is 0, correct? So, its last digit is 0, so it is divisible by by 10. Clear? For example, I'll give you to solve. Okay, so these four examples you have to solve by yourself. You have to check whether these numbers are divisible by 10 or not. So understood, today we have learned these three divisibility tests, test of 2, test of 5 and test of 10. All these divisibility tests write in your notebook, write each example of each test, and the examples which are given for homework, solve it. Okay, solve within this 1 hour. So thank you for today. Tomorrow we will learn next divisibility test. Okay. So if you have any doubt in this, you can ask. Thank you and have a nice day.